And a shot at goal by number 3, Ethan Harden. Number 11, Jackson Escobedo with a nice cross across the goal. Ethan Harden just missed. Goal kick for crossing. OCS, sorry. Number 11, Jackson Escobedo with a crossbar challenge. Saved by the keeper.
Saved by Valor.
Saved by the keeper, number zero, Valor Vaughn.
Thanks, I'm working in.
Yeah, I'll see you over there.
Into the Imperial Royals, number 33, Iomi Okedeji, number 18, Cash Barton.
Chop them up, Iomi. Chop them up! Come on, get forward, Jackson. Good timing on the play. Good timing on the play, Jake Carrasser.
Number 34 is a dangerous play, sliding into the keeper.
Why didn't Ballard play that? That should have been a... I hate that kid. He got a yellow one playing in Crooked Oak. He's a pump.
Number 34?
Yes. Just a pump.
Shot on goal by number 25 for OCS, saved by the keeper, Valor Bone. Caden Riley on the clearance for the Royals. Result of the play is a corner kick for OCS.
It looked like 34 went over there. Gave me knuckles. If I could tell him, I'm sorry. In the timeout there.
Becca. I say, where's Becca? Like, left the building?
Well, I don't know. Whatever they want. Well, I'll put down
there. Yeah, they need to get over on the field and start getting moving. I'll text her, see if she, I thought she was sticking around because we were talking. She asked me, like, are you going to coach him since the varsity's going to play some minutes? I was like, no, I want you to play certain girls in certain positions. Thank you.
Oh.
Okay, one of those is a foul.
Yeah.
Okay, he called it back.
Number 8, Braxton Drake, for Braxton Drake, drawing the contact. The result will be a direct hit for the Royals.
What the heck was that?
He slipped. He looked like he hurt his ankle. Yeah.
Returning the game for the Royals, number 7, Evan Rogers.
Hey, Nikki was wanting to know if we wanted to go to Cash Mart. Normally, it's a festival Saturday night.
Saved by the keeper, number 0, Ballard Vaughn.
Braxton went in for 14. Ryder, I think.
Number 8, Royals, number 8, Braxton Gray. Shot on goal, number 11, Jackson Escobedo, saved by the keeper for OCS. Returning to the game for the Royals, number 28, Caden Wynn. Caden Wynn, quick flush defending in front of goal.
Did Judah have his CCS shorts or just
some? Yes. Yeah, the CCS. We told him multiple times this year. I told him on Monday he was wearing CCS sweatpants, but they had like a little Hawaiian profile on the left leg. Those are ones you should buy just to wear at home or on the.
Oh, okay.
You know, after you can wear them at the game, you can wear them all night, stay warm, it's fine if you weren't school. So we had that conversation around. Him and several boys were wearing PE shorts today. Never been able.
I've seen him do it, leave the house. I'm like, you can wear those? He's like, yeah, on game day, so I know that.
The only thing they can wear outside of school dress code on game day is the ones you have to buy at the beginning of the year. Yes, you have to wear it with your jersey, but the ones you buy at the beginning of the year that are the black, just regular straight leg sweatpants, and they just say Royals right here.
Yes.
Purple letters with gold trim.
First year, get the school year.
Yeah. And that's for all sports, for all.
I think I missed that one, that's why I bought the sweats in the second round.
Yeah, those are
all the candles. Those are actually mine. Did they hold on Monday?
Yeah.
Because they keep fits them now.
Yeah.
So I'm going to give up my clothes and I'm going to take some hits. I actually went on vacation and I wore his shorts in the hot tub the night.
Dave and Buster the other day. Yesterday. I was like, dude, did you see your brother's shorts? Like, they were up here.
Yeah.
I was like, dude, I don't think those are supposed to be yours.
All of a sudden, yeah, they're right at that 10, 12 size, whatever.
Yeah.
Boys, I was dividing them up today. I was like, minimum, I'm going to start with you. I'll finish it. I'll help get 3 more weeks out of them.
True story.
He's busting today.
Yeah, he's a big kid. He's got taller this year. You can see it.
Yeah. I measured every 3 months. Height. I started doing their wingspan just for basketball, and then because I'm 3 inches wider than I am tall, so I eventually have longer reach for boxing what I used to do. But I measure him height and weight every 3 months. He shot up to 155 during football. He went from like 135 to 150 during football. And then basketball, he never gained any weight. Like, and you got there and say, man, basketball is so much harder than football, just the conditioning.
Right? Yeah.
That first week you're playing, but never put on any weight. Finally, he's gained about 5 pounds. His back, especially his feet out.
If he can just commit to the weight room.
Yeah.
That will help you greatly.
We got him trained over at the Y to be able to work out in there without adult supervision or whatever.
Yeah.
So he's going to be doing some of that this summer. But he's right there. His body's pushing testosterone. And with being out, you know, he's filling in. So his body's ready for it. I was wondering, how do you know when a kid's ready?
Hair on their
legs. Yeah. That's when you think they're ready to start working out?
Yeah. Well, you can start working out, but that's when they're starting to hit. You know, for boys, kid puberty, some hit it earlier, but a lot of them don't hit it until, 17, 18.
That's how I was. I hit puberty, but I didn't really put on muscle mass until between my junior and senior year before I got my strongest.
Yeah.
And then, because I was weak, if I was ready myself, my junior, sophomore, freshman year, compared to a lot of the other guys, but that's not the problem with this.
Yeah, women will get it. About 13, 14, they'll hit. They're hitting earlier. If you count them menstruating, it's when they start to hit puberty. Their bodies really start to change about 13, 14 minutes, and then you start lifting. Boys can lift then, it's not going to hurt them, but you won't see much whole body growth until you start seeing a lot of facial hair and hair in their legs.
Are there any summer football programs that you would recommend Junior to go to? You know, he wants to play outside linebacker. I think next year he also wants to come out and try for running back. If he doesn't start as a receiver, but he would like to play running back or attempt to. So is there anything football camps would you recommend sending him to over summer or anything? He always asks me. Football seems to be his favorite school.
I don't know. I've never been a camp guy because I've never been able to afford it. I've never had a kid in football, so I don't look for him, I got to tell you, soccer camps all over the place, but when it comes to positional stuff, just Google stuff in your area.
Okay.
I would look for stuff sponsored by a school or, there's a lot of collegiate things. They'll do stuff for underage kids. Those will be the better ones than just like...
Oh.
Gotcha. Team Tom's linebacker camp,
Yeah.
Get yourself a t-shirt.
Say you were there?
Yeah.
Ten on the field for the Royals. We need one more. Number 14, Ryder Guy joined the party. Also in the game for the first time this half, or tonight, number 21, Judah Helson. Number 6, E.J. Goodrich. Number 23, Caden Wagner. Number 30, Colin Ross. And number 15, Tarahan Shannon. Sorry, number 16.
I hadn't even noticed myself.
Come on, I mean, you can't be walking there. You gotta be sprinting in that space.
Number 16, Darwin Shannon with a nice tackle on the ball.
Lay it off to Caden. Oh, oh. Try to get fancy, but lay it off and play simple, listen. Job wag.
Number 33, Iomi Okedeji with his second shot at goal, second save by the keeper in half. Throw it to the Royals. Change our minds and throw in for OCS. Or it's a direct hit. Not quite sure what we're doing. Apologize, missed it in the massive wholesale changes at halftime. End of the game at keeper, number one, Joey the Potato Hurt.
The only kids that get that are the seventh grade boys.
All I know, dude was telling me about it.
He just yells potato.
Yeah.
He emailed me one time over the weekend, just randomly get an email from a, you know, you get an email from a cell phone number?
Yeah.
And there was a picture of a potato. And I was like, is this Joey? He's like, yeah. Is this Coach Drake?
Oh my God. I love the stories Judah comes home with about everybody's nicknames and just things that happened at practice.
I got him good today. Bauer was really nervous and embarrassed by his haircut.
I can see that he got a cut.
And I was like, it looks good, man. I was like, stop. They're messing with you because you're freaking out. But then Judah was like, so they get to English class, and she was like, Abel White really likes your haircut. And he didn't know that I'm listening. I'm standing right there, though. And I just looked at him, I was like, at least he's got a girl that likes him. And he's just kind of like, aww. He just sunk his head down. So that's definitely what single guys say to their buddies.
Yeah.
It was funny, though. He just kind of laughed, though.
He gives him a hard time about her. Trying to get him to quit. Might it be?
Come on, Naomi. I don't do too much. You better get your better guys in the mic.
Hard on Shane with clearance. For the Royals, number 8, Braxton Gray, giving the service.
Oh my gosh, Ryder almost had that.
Ryder guy with a near goal, saved by the keeper. Result of the play is another corner kick for the Royals. Number 8, Braxton Gray, sending the ball in. Number 23, Caden Wagner, with the amazing volley striking goal, saved by the keeper.
What was that, Kane Wagner?
End of the game for the Royals. Number 28, Caden Wynn. Number 11, Jackson Escobedo. Number 18, Cash Barton. Number 0, Ballard Vaughn. Number 24, Cashin Atkins. Number 20, Jay Kowser. Number 7, Evan Rogers. Number 17, R.K. Hunsinger, the third. And number 3, Evan Rogers. Not Evan Rogers, Ethan Harden. All the short kids look alike up here.
Looks like there's some chatter going on out there. Between 34 and 24.
Back in game, number 29, Jaden Cox.
Two Christian schools getting in a fight, always a good thing.
There are 12 players on the field in purple. Someone needs to leave. Coming right back out of the game, number 29, Jay Cox. Ethan Harden just shot a goal just wide.
right back at Evan. Switch it. Keep it going. All over.
Always by the Royals in the back part. Shot over the goal, number 11, Jackson Escobedo. Into the game for the Royals, number 24, Cashton Ashtons. Jackson Escobedo delivering the ball. Number 22, Caden Riley with the header at goal, just over the top. Number 11, Jackson Escobedo. That's the goal for his CCS Royals. Braxton Gray with the assist.
I got that on film good.
Shot at goal just by Jackson Espedo goes just wide. No one on the back post.
Oh!
were actually great taking another hard foul. Free kick taken by number 33, Iomi Okeji. Ethan Harden with the tap and go, blocked by the keeper. And then that's it.
Turn. Go ahead. Have it.
Number 11, Jackson Escobedo with another strike and goal. Saved by the keeper.
I didn't even see it.
Not even in the play. He makes the kid fall down.
I'm going to have to see that on film.
That is awesome. Oh my gosh, Cash. You're terrible.
Shot goal with number 39 for OCS. Saved by the keeper, Valor Bowen. Number 33, I don't know if Benji's showing the yellow card. I believe number 20 for OCS was as well. Whole slew of Royals joining the game. Number 23, Caden Wagner. Number 25, Joey the Potato Hurt. Number 16, Darlon Shannon. Number 30, Colin Roth. Number 6, E.J. Goodrich. In at striker, number 27, Judah Tolson. And number 14, Ryder Guy. Also number 28, Cameron Wynn. And number 20, Jay Kowser. One minute remaining. Caden Wagner with a strong clearance off the line, pays for it with contact. Junior Varsity Women take on OCS JV. Following that at 7:30, Junior Varsity Men.